is a hot topic. This is like a never-ending story. We are living in a crazy, unprecedented times. This has been never done or seen before. These times are really, really crazy and scary, scary, scary. And my videos is not to make you fear, no. Like, Jesus is in control, God is in control. I just wanna like unveil, you know, like the Greek meaning for unveiling is apocalypse. Apocalypse, you can look it up on Google, means to uncover, to unveil, to like see behind the veil. So apocalypse is to like reveal what's really there. So we are living right now in apocalyptic times. Oh man, it's not like, I think it is the end times. I think we are the generation that will see Jesus' second coming, which is like really crazy and exciting and everything all between. Guys, I am just a messenger, so please do not stone the messenger. I'm just a messenger telling you what's going on in the world, revealing what's going on about the great awakening, what's happening right now in the world, about all these plagues and coronavirus. And you know, the Bible says there will be pestilence, there will be plagues, there will be war, there will be death. It's all in the Bible, Revelation 13, when the seven seals are gonna get open. So go check it out. If you don't know the Bible, you have to read the Bible. That's the basis and foundation from every Christian. Okay, so I don't want to talk about the Bible in this episode. You read the title. I want to talk about Bill Gates. Yes, my favorite subject right now is Bill Gates. And he is a billionaire. He's the second richest man in the world. And you know what he's doing with all his money? So I'm gonna talk about this in this video. I'm gonna talk about Bill Gates and all his millions of money and what he's doing right now with it. Okay, so articles are popping up all over the internet, and this was 10 months ago, okay? This was 10 months ago before coronavirus hit. I think coronavirus is still a fake slash phantom virus to roll out something else. Go check it out. But anyway, this is another topic. Let's stay on the subject. So Bill Gates, he's a billionaire, and today we're gonna talk about what he's doing with his billions. He is building bunkers! OMG! Guys, Bill Gates is building bunkers. He's building in every house he has a bunker. And that's crazy. And these are articles from 10 months ago. 10 months ago, yes. And he is prepared. He is prepared for his own virus, because I still believe he created this virus and he's putting it out there, like all this fake thing. I don't know what exactly is there. Something that's killing people. But I don't know if it's a virus. I don't really know, but I know it's nothing good, and it came from Bill Gates and his lab, and he funded that with some money. Okay, what else is he funding right now? He's building bunkers. Billions. He spent like $20 million. What would you do with $20 million? He spent $20 million on bunkers in his house in Seattle. And then he has other houses. In every house that he has a bunker. And let me tell you why. Because when a plague comes, he's safe his ass. Yep. He's safe his ass. Because, like, if there is a chemical bio attack, you don't have 5 hours to get to your bunker. No. You have to get into your bunker within the next 30 to 60 seconds. Bam. Or, like, poof, a atom bomb, or poof, bio attack, or something that hits the world. It will wipe out all humanity. And Bill Gates, it's like, check out these articles, guys. So here's the first article. Bill Gates fears plagues that could wipe out humanity. And then here's another one. Bill Gates and American millionaires are building underground survival bunkers. The future is going to be rough. Wow, guys, check this out. Here's another one. How scared should I be of a contagious disease wiping out humanity? Wow. And then here's another one. It says the end of the world, apocalypse now. Billionaires are preparing for the apocalypse. Do they know something? Do they know really something that we don't know? And here's another one. Bill Gates thinks a coming disease could kill more than 30 million people within 6 months. And
and says we should be prepared for it as we do war. And guys, this is an article from 2018, April 22nd, 2018. This was an article from 2 years ago. Okay, here's one. This is really like creepy. It says, Bill Gates builds nuclear bunker, tells staff to leave the country. Okay, let's read this article. It says, Bill Gates urgently ordered the construction of a nuclear bunker in his Seattle property, has advised a long-term employee to leave the United States before the following weekend, says a member staff. And he says, he didn't say how long we should go away, but he says we should definitely leave before the following weekend, says Mr. Hall, a pool technician who says he watched the construction of the nuclear bunker and explains it's large enough to comfortably hold a handful of people only. Besides the nuclear bunker, several smaller tunnels and bunkers were built underneath the main residence, connecting them all up together in form of little small underground fortress. Oh my gosh. So explaining that the bunker has entrance and exits large enough for vehicles, as well as escape tunnels, decontaminating rooms, Swiss-made air purifiers, bulletproof hatches. Bill Gates apparently approved the final construction only after being repeatedly assured he and two others would survive in the underground structure in the event of a 500,000-pound blast. So these people are thinking those bunkers are gonna save them. These are their life policies. A bunker is a life policy. And what does billionaires doing with their money? Yes, they are putting it into bunkers. If Bill Gates is worried about a plague 2 years ago, should you be worried too? Hell yes, you should be worried. Is this realistic? Yes, absolutely. A bio attack is totally realistic in our days. Look what happened with coronavirus. All of a sudden, boom, within like just like a couple of days, boom, pandemic, boom, shutdown, boom, lockdown. So you should be really prepared for everything like these millionaires or billionaires. So it's not the question if you're gonna need it, it's the more the question when you're gonna need it.
Doesn't this prove what Bill Gates is all about? Like, he is building bunkers, he's saving his ass, he knows what's going on, he is totally prepared for the apocalypse. Wake up, guys, this is not a coincidence. No, this is all planned, this is all designed, destined from those rich billionaires, globalists to wipe out humanity, only that they are left in the country and then they want to build a new society, a new world order. Bill Gates is member of the new world order. He is getting invited to all these like secret parties, secret societies, Illuminati stuff, like really, really evil, joining together with evil, evil people. He joined together his forces with really evil, evil people. So he is not innocent. You think, oh, he just wants to save humanity. He just wants to help. No, Bill Gates doesn't want to help. Bill Gates wants to destroy. He wants to destroy everything we know as we know of. So this is just proof. 10 months ago, he's already talking about plagues. He's talking about vaccines. He's talking about bunkers. He knows exactly what's going on. Doesn't this prove that Bill Gates is like in the inside? We all, the American people, we are all in the outside. We don't know what's happening, or the whole world. We are just like average American people who don't know what's happening. Bill Gates is in the inside. He knows what's happening. You know what's even funny? Before the coronavirus hit, you know what happened? All these billionaires, all these CEOs just like stepped down from their position, and they knew exactly that something is gonna hit, and they all miraculously, all at once, like 2 weeks or so before the coronavirus hit, before WHO declared a pandemic, they all stepped down from their CEO position. Is this a coincidence? No coincidence. This is all planned. They know something that we didn't know. They unleashed coronavirus on us. They unleashed 5G on us. And I think now the society is going to get back open up. Thank you, Trump. Like, people, if you still hate Trump, stop, please. He is good. Without Trump, America has been already down in the gutter. Like, seriously. Trump really save America and he saved the world. And that's the reason why the globalists hate him. They want to get him out, and they're smearing his name back and forth since the day he was elected, since the day he came in office. And now I'm telling you, new things are going to happen to Trump. They're going to try to get him out again and try to indict him and try to like do other stuff and impeach him now that he wants to open back up the economy. Like, things are really, really crazy. Those globalist people, they are not nice people. They are very evil people. It's the secret society. It's the new world order. It's all these rich, rich people on the top of the food chain who are deciding like where life and society and the world is gonna go, because they have billions and billions and billions of dollars. And also multi-millionaires. They are all building bunkers. All billionaires, all multimillionaires have bunkers in their houses, like built in, airtight and purified and bulletproof bunkers that nothing can go in or out unless they open the door. And the only thing that can go in and out is their own asses, because they are gonna just save themselves. Sorry for my language, guys. My channel is not made for kids. I said this, not made for kids. So please watch your child, if they're watching this channel, to not watch it, because like, this is what I set my audience to be. Okay guys, another thing what's going on is that, as you can see, Bill Gates knows something that we don't know. So I just think like, this is all man-made. This is all happening because he wants it happening. And he's now popping up all over the place, talking about vaccines, talking about the mark of the beast, talking about the ID 2020, talking about travel certificate to get like vaccinated. And you know what the scary part is? Europe is already implementing that idea. And that is really, really scary. Europe is implementing the idea of forced vaccines in Denmark. People are already getting like chips in their hand, like implants. I mean, I don't want to be like a animal and get a microchip. That's why I don't microchip my animals, my pets. No, I don't like that. It's evil. It's a 666 sign. If you get the microchip in you, in your hand, the Bible says it will be on your forehead or on your right hand, and nobody can buy and nobody can like spend money and nobody can, unless you have this chip. Everything will be digital and cashless.
Next right and then left turn.
Okay, share this video with so many people as possible.